Let me show you how you can easily multiply yourself in your videos. I did this edit for Major League Baseball, where I had the underdogs go up against the champs. That was just a fun little video that I did as part of the creator class, where I was all six characters. Now let me show you how I shot these scenes. It's pretty simple to do, and all you really need is three different shots. So what I'll do is I'll analyze this scene here where I was wearing three different outfits, watching the other team play. We'll start by placing your phone or camera on a tripod. So with this technique, we just need to make sure that your camera is on the tripod the whole time without touching it. We just need it to be in the same spot without any movement at all. So let it run the whole time. Unless you have like a little remote that can control the recording, then you can turn it on and off, but I just recommend letting it run the whole time. It'll probably help if you have someone there to help place you in the right spot. Then you just need to make sure that you're in the right spot for every scene. All right, so with shot number one, I went right to the middle of the frame and I sat there. I started acting as if I was watching the game, but slightly intimidated watching the other team play. For shot number two, I changed my outfit and then I positioned myself over to the right side of the frame. I did the exact same thing. I was leaning against the fence for this one, but acting a little bit worried watching the other team play. So for this shot, you just gotta make sure that you don't overlap with the first scene that you took. This is where you get your shooter or your other person there to help make sure that you don't overlap. Now for the last shot, I changed my outfit again, and then I positioned myself on the left side of the frame. And again, I was acting as if the other team was way better than us and slightly intimidated by what was going on. And once again, just make sure that this character doesn't overlap with the other ones. Most phones nowadays have this grid line option that you can turn on and off. I highly suggest that you turn that on when you're shooting, which will help out a lot when it comes to positioning your characters in each frame. So I'll be using Final Cut Pro 10 for this edit. It should be the exact same steps for any other platform as well. First, I'll throw on the shot with me on the left side of the frame. Since this is the first shot on the timeline, I'll be using it as our foundation shot and using the environment around it. Next, we'll throw in a shot where I'm on the right side of the frame, and I'll place that right on top of the first one. When you're picking out these shots, you just gotta make sure that you choose ones where you're moving a little bit and showing some type of movement, just to make it more realistic and less like a photo. So for this scene here, we'll need to throw on the draw mask tool, which you can find in the effects tab on the bottom right side here. You'll start placing your key points just around your subject. I didn't have to be as precise with this one since I didn't move much in the scene, but it might be different depending on how you shoot yours. And then in the last shot, it'll be the one of me sitting down on the bench. I'll throw on the draw mask tool and then place the key points around me again. If you see any imperfections with your edit, try using the feathering tool in the draw mask tab to smooth it out. I didn't have to do it in these shots since everything came out pretty good, but again, it might turn out different for you. I did the exact same thing again for this scene as well, just making sure that each shot didn't overlap with the other. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe, but if you want to learn another fun and easy effect, make sure to watch this video here.